saw Dr. Rita Pratap, former head of the Department Drawing and Painting, University of Rajasthan, Jaipur. Module 5, I am going to speak on the Hakuhu White Phoenix period dated 645-710 AD. The name Hakuhu is used today rather loosely to cover the period spanning the later half of the 7th century. It is said that in the 6th year of his reign, Emperor Kotoku had changed his name of the era. Takya, great change to Hakuji, white peasant. And after one of his governors had caught a white peasant, but in the 8th century, the name was changed to Hakuhu, white phoenix, though the name still appears in the history books. Hakuhu marked the rise of Fujiwara family from the old Nakatomi. Following the elimination of the Soga clan in a palace coup, Kotoku issued the Takya reform edicts from Nariwa, not Asuka, and established a Chinese-style political structure embodying the power in the person of the emperor. Governing a still non-existent city was a minister of the center, Nakatomi Kamatari, the prime engineer of the downfall of the Soga, later given the Fujiwara title on his deathbed. A great minister of the left, Abe Kurahashimaro, and a great minister of the right, Soga Kuraya Madal Shikawa Maro, the builder of the Yamada Dera in Asuka. The official advisors to these ministers were Buddhist priests recently returned from long and intense years of study in China. There was a drastic change. Province officials were appointed. Official roads and toll stations were set up and land put under government control. New taxes were instituted. The traditional Omi and Muraji ranks were dissolved and the whole UG and related economy B system abolished. Private land belonging to former nobles was confiscated. Among the edicts was the law of Hakusu, a regulation to reduce the construction of mounded tombs and prohibit the deposit of grave goods. This law was prompted by the inordinate expense of burials and lavish ceremonies they entailed. Emperor Tenji suffered the ongoing change. Gradually, the Japanese gave attention in developing their political system, that is, the construction of a formal palace and adjunct capital city as the bureaucracy demanded. Tenji's successor Temu survived a brief revolt and was formally crowned in 673. Temu set himself in a large new style palace known as Kiyo Migahara in Asuka and absorbed himself in the Buddhist affairs. After his death in 686, Jito, his official consort, succeeded him. Fujiwara was laid out due north of Asukien, an open area defined by the Yamato Sanzan. Three small cone-shaped hills and crossed diagonally by the Asuka River. The palace was situated in the middle of the north side in such a way that the Asuka River would pass but not cut its southwest corner. Keeping the Chinese capital cities as model with odd and even numbered streets to conform to the balance of nature. The main avenue led up through the center to a large red gate opening into the palace complex. With the stimulation of the central political authority, religious developments were in the forefront. With the stimulation of the central political authority, religious developments were in the forefront. In 654, Japanese priest named Dosho introduced the sect Hoso. Its sutra shaped the religious thought in many of the early temples. In 679, all temples were told to adopt a Chinese style name. For example, the Ikaruga Dera or Wakakusa Dera became Horyuji. In fact, it was formerly Horyu Gakumonji, that is, prosperous law temple of learning. The Taoist elements which penetrated the arts did so through the medium of Buddhism. The earliest Buddhist works served a major social, commemorative, and memorial function. They were often ordered by a wife, son, or other kin to ensure repose for the soul in paradise. Temples built by Prince Shotoku and icons later made for them were dedications. For instance, the original Horyuji and Tachibana Dera were dedicated to the prince father Yomi, whose name was Tachibana no Toyohi, and Chuguji to his mother. The bronze Shaka triad and tapestry mandala of heavenly longevity of the Horyuji were dedicated to the prince and his wife and relatives. Long life was a pervasive theme, not only in the subject of the mandala itself, but in many of its individual motifs, tortoises, sun and moon symbols, the rabbit in the moon mixing the axler of eternal life, and probably when it was complete, the mountain of the blessed as seen through the eyes of a Buddhist. A precipitous landscape like the one on the large back panel of the Tamamushi shrine, where sun and moon symbols can also be seen. The base of Buddhism was being broadened by these Taoist elements as Buddhism in Japan began to formulate the notion of an existence regarding as rebirth in a land of eternal bliss. Prince Shotoku is said to have studied and annotated the Hokkeke-yo, the Lotus Sutra, the text expounding pure land, the three temples, Horenji, Hokkeji, and Horyuji. Horyuji Nara. The Horyuji had been destroyed in fire in 669 and was rebuilt a little to the northwest of the first temple in the last 15 years of the century. The plan of Horyuji complex at Nara consists of the western area, that is the main south gate, middle gate, golden hall, five-story pagoda, hall of the sutra, bell hall, lecture hall, western octagonal hall, treasury, eastern area, octagonal area, site of the Ikaruga Dera and Chuguji. In the illustration of the golden hall of Horyuji Nara shows the pagoda of the Horyuji with the drawing of cross section of the pagoda showing the way in which the building is supported by a central beam made from a single tree trunk. In the plan of Horyuji, one can see the positions of number 1 as middle gate, number 2 as pagoda, and number 3 as the golden hall. The Nehan or the Parinirvan or death of Buddha in pagoda of Horyuji Nara. The pagoda contains some 90 clay statues telling stories from the life of Buddha. The oldest dates from 711, whilst others are later replacements. The The most remarkable example of the early tang style is the Japanese bronze Amida triad within the Tachibana shrine, which is named for the lady of wealth and aristocratic birth who gave the shrine to Horyuji. It dates from about 700. This is some 80 years after the beginning of the Tang dynasty in China. But Japanese art in Chinese style is always subject to time lay. Thus, triad represents early 7th century Tang style. The Amida Triad. The Amida Triad from Tachibana Shrine, Horyuji, Nara Prefecture, Japan, and belong to 8th century. It is made of gilded bronze and is housed in a wooden tabernacle of the same time. Three major units make the composition: a flat base, a background screen in the form of a tripitch, and three major images which sit or stand on lotuses rising from the bronze base. The total ensemble is approximately 2.5 feet high. In the center, Amida Buddha, Amitabha, is sitting on a lotus flanked by two bodhisattvas standing on lotus, Sheshi left and Kanan right. In the background are Apsaras seated like a triad on lotus flowers. The Buddha's right hand makes the lotus holding gesture, and the raised hand of each bodhisattva makes a gesture of reassurance. The gestures are gracious, and easy naturalism informs the faces and parts of the drapery. The figures are frontal, and a certain rigidity is evident in the drapery, in the poses of the bodies, and in particular in the mouth of the central image. The tripitch screen behind the main images is executed in the most beautiful low relief. Across the bottom of the screen, little octopi twine their tentacles around stems of lotuses on which angels are sitting. The octopi connect the screen radically with the base, which represents a pond, cast like the screen in low relief. The Amida figure has a fairy halo signified by flames. At the very top of the screen, the earliest Buddhist painting is remarkably preserved. Fully developed entity known as the Tamamushi Shrine in Horyuji, Nara. It consists of a model of a temple intended to house small images, a box-shaped pedestal and a flared base with four legs. The cloud brackets are arranged in a radial manner. The Shaka triad for which it was built has been missing since 13th century. The inner walls are lined with thin bronze plaques bearing rows of little reposes. Buddhas, the so-called thousand Buddhas, the edges are decorated with the wing sheaths of the Yamatomushi beetle is inserted into metal openwork, and it is these iridescent wings which give the shrine its name. This common beetle, the Yamatomushi, is widely collected in the months of July and August for its attractive iridescent green and red strips which run the length of the sheets. Recent research has revealed evidence of the use of both oil and lacquer paints. Beefsteak plant shisho seed oil was mixed with lead oxide Mitsuda. Yellows were applied for skin colors and blue-greens for vegetation. Lacquer was mixed with red pigments for clothes and tigers and black for physical body details. The gaudy lotus petals at the top and foot of the pedestals are crude additions, out of scale and damaging to the appearance of each panel of painting. The front doors bearing paintings of a pair of Deva kings on dwarf demons. Each side door has two bodhisattvas on twin lotuses. The large back panel has three spired stupa-shaped structures with statues visible in the arched niches. Ascetics in rocky caves, fabulous birds, flowers, heavenly angels, and a sun and moon. The scenes on the front of the pedestal may be a memorial service. In the illustration, two monks flank a relic container and two incense burners in vertical alignment. Apsaras descend from above. The back illustrates Mount Sumeru, the Buddhist holy mountain rising from the ocean, protected by a dragon building at its foot and summit, birds in the lower corners, and a moon and toad and three-legged sun crows in the upper right and left corners. Small figures occupy appropriate places around the panel. The large temple building at the bottom has a seated image in the central bay and an adoring bodhisattva in each side bay. In the rare use of Jataka stories in Japan in the Theravada Hinayana tradition, two are included on the sides of the pedestal. From the large number of the so-called birth stories of Buddha or his earlier existence, the two are chosen of the pre-existing Buddha sacrificing himself to save the starving tigers and sacrificing himself to hear the second stanza of the poem. These are narratives in landscape settings as though reproduced from the hanging scrolls. In the first story, the prince hangs his jacket on the flowering tree. His body and the tree in parallel curves, and the story increases in pace, reaching an abrupt climax as the prince throws himself off the cliff onto the bamboo groove below. Bamboo sprouts from the thin layers of the rocky edges. Wisteria hangs across the mouth of the cave, and small lotuses and wispy cloud add a cheerful touch. The other story is more difficult to tell coherently. It is not a straightforward narrative, but a psychological test. As a Brahman ascetic, Buddha encountered Indra in the guise of a demon who quoted half a stanza of a poem but volunteered a second half only if his appetite of human flesh could be satisfied. Making an agreement with the Indra, Buddha carved the full stanza on the rock and offered himself. Indra relented, however, and spared him. The demon is seen at the foot of the panel as a black-spotted, ferocious creature clad in loincloth. The Taoist motifs in the Buddha themes lead one to suggest that the Tamamushi shrine was a memorial. These motifs are chiefly in the works which were memorials or dedications, as they stress long and eternal life and natural relationships designed to put the spirit of the dead in harmony with the universe. Portrait of Prince Shotoku and two young boys. Probably his sons. This is in the collection of Imperial Household Agency, Tokyo, and is dated to 684. This painting done on paper shows Prince Shotoku and two young boys. They were included in the gift to the Imperial Household in 1876 from Horyuji. The prince and presumably his two sons are painted in light pastel colors at the foot of the sheet of paper set in a fashionable 3/4 viewpoint. The central figure is overbearing in size. The costumes are broadly shaded in strong folds and flared at the ankle to reveal under trousers. The toes of the shoes are finely pointed. All hands are covered. Prince Prince Shotoku wears a long robe and has looped his hair according to the required style, but his trousers hang loose. The oversized symbol is carried on its edge, not flat as protocol would dictate. The figure on the right has only a cover. As there is no sword handle, and the figure on the left has an old tassel, its end resembling a sword sheath. In fact, the lower body is turned more in a way common to Hakuku rendering. The Horyuji murals. The most magnificent examples of the late Hakuku painting are murals of the rebuilt Horyuji Golden Hall. These murals are said to be very rare ones, and moreover, it was for the first time that the monastery was highly decorated. Earlier, the Buddhist halls were decorated by woven, painted, or embroidered silk hangings. The Golden Hall was completed sometime between 680 and 690, and by 711, the murals were finally painted. These murals are 3 meters high. The 4 large central ones measure about 2.5 meters across, and the 8 corner ones 1.8 meters. The artisans were immigrants of Korean and Chinese descent who were given responsibility to decorate the palaces and temples. The Tahio Ryo decree of 701 established a painter's bureau, Idakumi no Tsusuka, under the Ministry of Internal Affairs, which was presided over by 3 civil officials. The bureau had 4 master painters, Ishii, and 6 ordinary painters, Idakumi, living in metropolitan area, and several groups of private painters living in provinces, Sato Eshi, who could be summoned to the capital for large-scale projects. For thousands of years, the institution of official painters continued to exist until the Meiji Restoration of 1868. 4 large panels depict the 4 paradises. At that time, these doctrines were popular in Japan. On the east wall is the paradise of Shakyamuni. On the northeast, that of Yakushi Buddha of healing. And on the northwest, that of Miraku, Maitreya. And on the west, the paradise of Amida, Amitabha, whose cult was the most popular of all. Between these are found 8 vertical panels, each containing a bodhisattva. The paradise is purely formal arrangement with the presiding deity on the lotus throne in the center, beneath a canopy of flowers and flanked by bodhisattvas and attendants. Amida Triad, Kondo Hall of Horyuji Nara Prefecture, Japan, Nara period dated to 710, destroyed in 1949. Exact replica of Horyuji Museum, Nara. The balanced composition used as a jeweled canopy with a general indication of hills behind. The main concentration is on 3 figures. Amida is shown accompanied by 2 bodhisattvas and dematerialized souls. The most famous one of the 3 figures painted is of the head of bodhisattva Canon Avalokiteshvara in Amida Triad on the west wall of Horyuji, 701. Damaged in fire in 1945. The full figure has full sensuous lips and long deep set eyes. They have the same sensuous and fleshy presence as Chinese high tank paintings of the period. such as those in Tonghuang Caves during 642 and 698 AD, with the bodies slightly twisted and relaxed in three bhangar contrapose, which separates the planes of torso, upper and lower abdomen, and places the weight on one leg with the other slightly lifted in motion. The paintings are drawn on dry plaster with a sweeping brush line of marvelous fluency. To make the murals, the Konda wall surface was first covered with a layer of fine white clay. Then the artist transferred the design from a pouncing pattern using a fine, even red or ink line, then added colors including cinnabar, red ochre and red lead for the reds, ochre and litharge for yellow, malachite for green and azurite for blue. In the painting, pigment is heaped up in a rich impasto in the rendering of flowers and jewelry. A hint of shading in the composition gives an effect of plastic solidity. The exact date of these paintings is not known, but most authorities place them between 680 and 710. The Ngaiko scrolls. Because of the absence of historical documents, it is not certain that by whom and where were the Ngaiko scrolls executed. Though it is sure that the scrolls of the illustrated scriptures of causes and effect or Ngaiko were copied in Japan from Chinese original. An example is of a miniature of the second scroll, first part, 8th century, painting on paper and belonging to Kyoto. In Japanese collection, four versions were painted in the mid-8th century, a fifth probably half a century later. In several Western museums, few fragments have been seen. The Ngaiko tells the story of the life and previous lives of the Buddha. The illustration runs about the text, reading, as do all Far Eastern scrolls, from right to left. Although these incidents belong to India of the 6th century BC and are set like the Tonghuang paintings in the modern dress of Tang China, they are also notable for the native charm and clarity and for the skill with which incident follows incident. The same figure appearing again and again in a continuous landscape panorama. The illustration shows Kondo Golden Hall of Yakushiji Nara. This temple is dedicated to the Buddha of healing. Yakushiji Triad, dated 726, made of gilt bronze, and at present it is in the Golden Hall of Yakushiji Nara, Japan, and belong to Nara period. Yakushiji is the name of the healing Buddha, sometime one of the Buddhas of the four directions, and his attribute is a medicinal jar, which he usually holds in the palm of one hand. The main image of the principal hall at Yakushiji is a seated Yakushiji, flanked by a pair of bodhisattvas, often referred to as the moon and sun, or Gekko or Neko bodhisattvas. The figures are about 10 feet in height. Their halos are modern with lumpy cloud pattern. The bodhisattvas are not stiffy frontal but a hip short pose with a gentle sway of the body. One leg slightly bent and the other thrust forward. The draperies flow easily. The treatment of the hand is rounder and fuller and the body is fleshy. Detail of the seated gilt bronze figure of the Yakushi Naorai, the Buddha of healing, second half of the 7th century, Yakushiji Nara. This statue forms the part of the group known as Yakushi Triad, in which the Buddha is flanked by separate figures of the Bodhisattvas, Gakko and Nakko. When the wife of Emperor Tomu was suffering from an eye disease, he ordered the erection of a temple of Yakushi-ji. The Yakushi-ji has a record of fine fires, leaving only the East Pagoda, the lone survivor to modern times. The illustration shows the East Pagoda of Yakushi-ji Nara. Another example is the bust of the bronze statue of Shokenon dated 670 Yakushi-ji Nara. This standing bronze statue of Shokenon was made a few years earlier than Yakushi Triad and probably from the same workshop. The very high ornamented bun, like the Bodhisattvas of the Triad, appears here for the first time in its most exaggerated form. The upper torso is softly articulated and the right drapery scarves make a series of arcs and contribute to the form of the body. This canon is an inaugural example of the Indianization of the early tongue style. Kofukuji Nara. The temple has a full set of the family of Shaka, dry Lakko images housed in the Western Golden Hall. These consisted of the customary platform sculptures of the Buddha, Bodhisattvas, four heavenly kings, and probably a pair of monks like the intercessors, but these have all disappeared. Around them were 10 great disciples, Judai Deshi, and 8 guardians, Hachi Bushu, and a probable total of 27 statues. The hall was erected in 734, and one assumes that the figures were made at the same time and the platform images were in the same technique. The checkered story of the Kofukuji, the 15th century 5-storied pagoda, now Japan's second largest, is the fifth on the spot. Included the thoughtfulness disposal of 4 of the great disciples to private collectors, and all were tragically destroyed in the great Kanto earthquake of 1923. The foreignism in the 8 guardians are specially conspicuous at the junctures, red or dark skins. Indian costumes, Central Asian armor, and animal skin of Gobuju, the bird head Karura, and the 3 faces and 6 arms of Asura. These demigods are a desperate collection of Indian spirits of water, music, earth, serpent, bird, and others which were pressed into service of Buddhism and personified within the anthropomorphic tradition of Indian art. Example of the 8 guardians, Hachi Bushu in dry lacquer technique, Katshichu are Kinnara and Karura, one of the 8 guardians of Shaka. They are painted in dry lacquer, slightly smaller than life size, Kofukuji, Nara and Karura. Head of Buddha. Kofukuji Nara, this is all that remains of a bronze Buddha triad cast in 678 and destroyed in fire.